What?
Come on, make some noise. I Justine's in the house.
Hi.
How cool.
This is exciting. Thanks for having me.
Oh, of course. Thanks for being here.
It's got my little name.
Got your name
stuff?
Up there.
Wow.
Isn't that nice?
Yeah, thank you.
Only the best. So excited. Thank you for being here. And thank you for taking time out of your ridiculously busy schedule to hang out with us. What have you been? I just saw you were in a helicopter, a doorless helicopter ride the other
yes.
day.
Yes. So there's this company called Fly Nyon, and they do helicopter rides, but they're like photo tours. So they take you to all of the hot spots, and you can tell them where you want to go. They take you there, and like the helicopter hovers, so you can take photos and video. It was just so awesome, and I was absolutely terrified.
I was going to ask, is that not a terrifying experience? Because I could have sworn that you said doorless helicopter.
No doors. And so one of my friends, Sarah, she's like, yeah, so I booked us a cool helicopter ride. I was like, yeah, that's cool. And I'm like, inside, I'm like, why would you do something like that? But it ended up being so much fun, and I'm so glad I did it.
Did you know from the onset that there were no doors? Or were you sitting there waiting for them to close, only to realize as you slowly pulled away that they weren't going to close?
I did not know until I watched the safety video, and like, I wish I was filming because
it's usually
I saw
too late
the people,
to back out.
Like,
then.
Their feet were hanging off the helicopter, and I said, wait, this is what we're doing? Are you serious?
Wow.
And it was, but it actually wasn't bad. Yeah, you're strapped in pretty good, so that was good. It worked out well.
Well, I'm glad to hear that. What other crazy things have you been up to lately? I feel like the helicopter's a tough one to top, right?
Well, like, it's been rough lately because, like, Zelda.
Yeah, tell me about it.
And then Mario Kart just came out, which I started playing that, but, like, mm-hmm. I'm still not over Zelda. But now I'm playing at, like, a healthy amount.
Okay.
You know, just, like,
you've
casually.
You've got it managed?
Yeah, now? Like, 20 minutes, I'll go find, like, a seat or, you know, like, a shrine and just kind of walk around, you know, cook some food. But
well, it's perfect for that. You could pick it up and play for a little bit.
Well, yeah, that was before. After I beat it, I was like, all right, good. This is fine. But, you know, for a while, I was like, this is just incredible.
And, one quick Zelda question while I have you here? Because I saw you playing it live, and you had so many hearts. How did you get so many hearts? You had like 20 hearts, and I have like 10, and I felt really accomplished.
Oh, no. You got to get at least 13 going? So you can get the Master Sword.
Yeah,
I basically was just shrine grinding. I was like, we're going to get as many as we can.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to get this Master Sword, and then maybe I'll go outside today.
All right. So, well,
we can talk about this all day long.
I know. I was going to say, I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't take us off of this
for
now. But I could talk to you for the entire 30 minutes.
We'll chat
about
later.
Zelda. We'll get to it later. I do want to go back a little bit. You've been in this game for 10 years, at least. More than that you've been putting these videos up and doing all this.
Thanks for reminding me.
Yeah, well,
it's cool. No big deal.
Well, the reason I bring it up is because not a lot of people have been able to sustain and do it for as long as you have, as successfully as you have. And I'm really curious about your beginning and what inspired you to start making videos in the first place. Because your first one was, I was going back into the archives, the oatmeal draw, you got hit in the head with the apple, like the early, early stages of I Justine. What was the idea back then? What was the goal?
Well, honestly, a lot of those was because I was editing on Premiere and I was teaching myself to edit on Final Cut. So that was just purely me like trying to teach myself to edit and use like a different system because I was also using Avid at the time. So some of those were just like self-tests on Avid trying to learn. But really it was just for fun. And I would do, you know, different travel things and just post videos and make fun things. So it really wasn't for a job per se. It was just because I actually enjoyed it, which is different now because people are making videos to become a YouTuber, where I was just being a crazy person posting videos on the internet. So now at least it seems a little more sane.
Was there ever, even though you're just doing it to kind of learn those programs, obviously you're learning how to edit, you're learning video, were there aspirations of being a filmmaker or something like that that maybe have morphed over time as it's sort of become its own separate kind of career entirely?
Yeah, for sure. And I was also doing it too to show people that I did know how to edit because I was doing freelance graphic design and video production. So it was also to be like, hey, look, I know how to edit. Hire me to edit whatever it is that you need edited. So there was that. And then it sort of morphed into something more where people said, hey, can you post more videos of yourself doing silly things and asking questions? And then it really did stem from that.
Yeah. What for you was the turning point video where you realized, oh man, this is becoming a thing? Because I know your phone bill video kind of blew up and that was huge.
I think it probably was that video.
Was it that one?
It was more something that made it an actual thing.
Yeah.
And it maybe people took me a little bit more seriously, which is kind of hard to do because I was posting the craziest things online. But I think it made people realize that this is something and this could potentially be something more. And then, you know, from that, I mean, so many other opportunities just kept coming in. So I feel like that was the one for me that made me realize that, hey, this internet thing, there's something here.
When a video does so well and markedly better than your other videos that you've produced, do you have a moment where you're like, well, I guess I need to make more videos like this one? Or no, do you just keep going and you're like, well, now that all these people have discovered me, they'll see all the other fun things that I do? Like, what happens mentally as a creative person when you have that kind of success over one of those videos?
It's a little bit of all of that. There's also the freak out because you get a lot of extra hate whenever a video does well, which is always a good thing. So I feel like even throughout the week, I'm like, man, nobody has hated me for like 14 hours. Like, what's wrong? I got to do something. So, you know, you do have sort of that sense of, okay, I should maybe create some more of this content because people really did enjoy it. Mm-hmm. But sometimes it could just be a fluke thing and there's no rhyme or reason sometimes why a video does well. So you kind of just have to sort of figure that out. And also it's great because you can speak to your audience. Say, hey, what do you guys like? They're like, we like more of, you know, this. Oh, I just noticed your shoes. Those are great, by the way. Very, very nice.
Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm. They also, I don't know how to demonstrate this casually, but they say game over on the bottom.
Yeah, I have those ones too.
You're familiar with them?
Yes. Oh, man. I should have worn them. I didn't know. I'm sorry.
This is, okay.
Sorry, guys.
We can figure this out.
Yes, we'll outfit coordinating next time.
Next time, we'll do it. I want to talk to you a little bit about, because you mentioned how if you don't get hated on for 14 hours, something's going on or whatever. Let's talk about that community for a second, because I think in terms of fan bases and as fan communities go, one, you've seen it change over you know, the past however many years it's been. I'm not going to put a number on it.
It's okay. It's all right. It's almost 11 now.
It's 11 years, right?
Yes.
So you've seen it sort of change and morph and go from an ebb and flow of all these different things. What has been your way of responding to and dealing with that community? Because it can be really challenging at times.
It can. And I mean, I think, you know, it does affect you at different times in your life, too. Because sometimes you're having, like, a really crappy week and somebody says something that you're just like, I can't take it anymore. Why are you being so mean? I'm sorry you don't like my hair today. And you're just like, the stupidest thing will set you off. But you do have to understand that sometimes a lot of these people are, you know, hating on you because they're coming from a place of like hurt and pain. So a lot of times they're saying these awful things about you to more or less sort of make up for something that is missing in their life or something else is going on. So I do try to keep that in mind. And sometimes I'm like, well, you know, what is that thing? Like, why are you upset? And then try to have a conversation with the person, and then they apologize. And a lot of times, people don't think that you ever actually see that comment.
Right, that's where a lot of it comes from, right? They think there's this anonymity behind it, that they can say whatever, and it's never going to get back to you, and it's never going to hurt you, because you get a million comments.
Like, so yeah, and I
sit
there.
It has to have a profound impact when you turn around and go, dude, that hurt.
I know, and I mean, I literally sit on Twitter and everything, like, all day long. So it's like, I think a lot of that misconception of, you know, a lot of celebrities and people, most of the time, you know, when we're not doing something else like this, like, we're on our phone. And, I mean, my phone is right here, so
I saw that you brought it with
you. It's not too far away.
Well, it's also tough, right, because there's a perceived level of intimacy, I think, that's unique to the field that you're in and to, like, internet personalities and YouTube stars, because you're not going to a theater and watching something with a group of people. You're not even sitting at home. You're watching it inches away from your face whenever you want on your phone on your device, and so you become connected to this person. And so they say things that they wouldn't normally say. Have you had weird interactions with them, like, or interesting interactions, we'll say, that over the years with your different fan base and stuff like that?
Yeah.
I just want to start with, I know that a majority of your fan base is not weird or interesting, and they're awesome people, because I was tweeting with them and coming up with questions.
Yeah, that's cool.
But,
well, no, and I think that's, one of the things is, it's always weird when someone will take a picture from you, like, from afar, and be like, oh, I just wanted to say hi. No, I'm scared and I was nervous. I'm like, well, now this is even more weird because now you just look a creep shot, like, from far away. And then I'm like, you should have said hi. So, I mean, that's always funny. I think one time in an airport, some kid ran up to me and just, like, had his phone. He goes, I know you. Took a picture in front of my face and then ran away. I was like, well, do you want, like, a selfie? Or, like, you just want me, like, looking like this, like, looking crazy. So, I mean, there's those things, too. But sometimes I do have, like, very young audiences, too. So, you know, that's... You don't normally go up to strangers, even though I feel like to us, like, we're not really strangers to them, too, which is also very confusing for parents when someone's like, Mom, I gotta go say hi to this girl. I see her on the internet, and that's strange, you know? So there is that sort of conversation that has to be had also with the parent. It's like, so what do you do? Why is my child watching you?
So who are you?
I was like, no, it's fine. I promise. Yeah, baking, cooking videos, they're games. It's okay.
I saw a quote not too long ago from you. So they were asking you to give advice to other up-and-comers, and I believe your quote was, don't quit your job right away. And then you paused, and you said, actually, you know what, maybe quit your job. Maybe that's the motivation you need. And so...
Did I say that? Because that's good.
Yeah, it was pretty good. So my follow-up to that was, when were you able to quit your job, and do you regret maybe not doing it sooner?
Yeah, I mean, I think I quit my job at a good time, but I definitely shouldn't not have quit it when I did, for sure. No.
Why not?
Oh, I mean, I wasn't making money doing YouTube, so I was just like, mostly just quitting it in hopes that I would be able to survive off of doing like freelance stuff. Because even at the time of quitting, I wasn't making money like on YouTube. That wasn't a thing yet. So I was more or less just sort of putting a lot of effort into something that I didn't know what it was even going to be. And in return, I was still doing like freelance design and stuff like that. So I did have that to fall back on. But, you know, to go off of that quote, I don't think there really is a good time to know when you should quit. And I just sort of have that mentality of, I know I've been through a lot of random things, and I have the sense of like, no matter what I get myself into, I'm going to be able to find a way out. And so with that mindset, I've been able to get, I think, to where I am now. And sometimes I'm not sure if I'm ever able to dig myself out of the holes that I get myself into. So I just try to find a bigger shovel. So it's good.
That's another great quote.
It's good.
You just got to find a bigger shovel.
Amazon. I have an affiliate link, so that's follow spells.
You're gonna have an Amazon link to giant shovels. Is that what the game plan is?
Maybe. This is great.
It's a very literal beat of advice. Just like get a literal giant shovel, and you'll be fine. So let me back up for a second, then, because that's right. You're doing this at a time when monetization isn't necessarily immediately obvious, and you're kind of just putting your faith in this thing that's growing and growing. Was the goal to be as big as you could be on YouTube, or was the goal to be as big as you can be so it could open doors to other things?
I honestly have no idea what I was doing. Yeah. No, and I mean, the goal, I think, for me was, you know, at the time I was doing videos with my friend Desiree, and we were doing podcasts and stuff like that, and I just knew that I loved tech, I loved video games, and I loved Apple, and, you know, I had a blog, and even before that, I was on, like, all kinds of, like, Apple forums, and this was back in, like, high school and even middle school. You know, I was like chatting with people on Nintendo forums in like sixth grade before video or anything was even out there. So I'm not really sure what I was doing, but I knew I was building something or trying to get to something. And I guess it was ultimately this, which didn't really exist. So I think, you know, for a lot of people who are doing something maybe different right now, you might not know what you're building towards, but it's something. So if you love it, don't quit.
Also great. You're just a fountain of great advice. You're doing a great job. Well, I bring it up because what I find fascinating about like looking into your career and all the things you've done so many different things. You've done so much. You've been on film and TV. You wrote a book. You were just on Chopped recently.
Yes. Like, oh my gosh, the most fun thing ever.
How was that experience?
I had no idea how hard it would be. I mean, you see these people on Chopped and... You know, not really being someone who I would ever consider a cooking expert, it was really difficult. But it was fun because it was also with a bunch of other fellow internet people, but those other internet stars also were chefs, so that was the problem. But it was fun. It was just really cool being in the audience and being on the show and, like, you know, seeing the audience reaction, too. But it was so fun. I would definitely do it again.
Yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. Was it your first time on a show sort of that scale? Like, Chopped is a pretty...
For Chopped, yeah. I was on Chopped Junior as a judge before which was so cool. And I was so impressed by, you know, these kids cooking. And then I was up there. I was like, well, these 8-year-olds did better than I did. So I've got a lot to live up to.
Just thumbs up across the board. This is better than I could do. Yeah, that's pretty amazing. One of the other things that you've gotten to do throughout your career is similar to this. You've gotten to interview a lot of really cool people for a lot of different movies and things like that. What's someone that you were most nervous to meet or someone that you were really excited that you got to talk to?
Wow, I think this was a long, long time ago. It was The Rock. So this was
that's
before.
That's my dream right there.
I had never done any interviews or anything before, so I had no idea what I was doing. So this was in Vegas, and I'm embarrassed that I even did this, and I don't even know if the video is still up. But
I sense a great story coming.
Yeah, well, so I ran into this little like kiosk at the like in Vegas on the Strip where you can like swap your face with somebody else's face, and I was like, oh, I can swap my face with The Rock. This is incredible. So I got a bunch of these prints printed.
You got prints?
I did. And then I ran into him at the red carpet. I was like, hey, I'm Justine. I've got a picture for you. Can you sign it? I signed one for you. And it was a picture of my face on his face. And I signed one for him, and then he signed his for me. And it was just very strange.
That kind of speaks... I think everyone in the world has always assumed The Rock to be an awesome person, but you've got to be a special kind of person to have a fan come up and go, sign this, and it's a picture of your face on someone else's body.
It was so strange. I had no idea what I was doing. I'd never done an interview before. I'd never been on a red carpet, and I was like, that sounds fun, cool. So sometimes being naive, you know, works out to your advantage. So I wouldn't say that everyone is like that, but The Rock, Dwayne, is just, he's... Yeah. Unbelievable. He's so great.
Yeah. He's a special one. So I want to talk to you. Also, what I love about just your wide breadth of things that you've covered and done throughout the years, you're obviously very much into gaming, very much into tech. You have your Tech Tuesdays.
Usually never posted on Tuesday.
Never posted on a Tuesday.
Today it was. Was today Tuesday?
Oh, yeah.
Is today Tuesday?
You did a video today.
My God, it's actually a Tuesday.
You nailed it. Round of applause for her nailing the deadline.
You.
Come on. This is cause for celebration.
On a Tuesday.
You did it.
I Don't wanted get used to ask, to it.
You've looked at and reviewed so many crazy things over the year. What is your weirdest, why does this exist gadget that you had to look at?
Oh, man. You know, I love everything, and I even think that it's like, why does this exist? I'm sure someone is going to find a reason for it. The most recent one that I did that I was super disappointed about, which they ended up reaching out and trying to make things right, is a coffee cup that connects to your phone. I've never had so much trouble with something, so I think they had like 1% of the cups that connect to your phone, Bluetooth, to heat your coffee, didn't work, so apparently I got the 1% in there.
Fault unit, it could happen.
So, I know, so they said it was an early one, so they're going to resend, so I'm going to have to check it out. And
you'll
do
give it another
that.
Go.
And I've also had some trouble with some drones, like the GoPro Karma, if you remember that whole thing.
Yeah.
I basically took it out in my backyard, took it up for 2 seconds, it slammed into the side of my house. And I was like, oh, let's try it again. A good idea. Does the same exact thing. So, you know what they say about insanity.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. So you did three other times, I take it.
I did.
You finally boxed it
back.
I was
like, all right, I think this is broken now.
Perfect. I also wanted to ask you, obviously you have your phone with you, it doesn't leave your side. I was following your red phone saga, which I thought was great.
Oh, my baby, yeah.
I know. I really enjoyed, I was watching the video on the train a couple of days ago of when you explained that you had to return it. And I was like on the edge of my seat of like, why did she return it? Why did she return it? And it kept buffering.
Yeah,
and
then
finally you were like, red's not for me. And I was like, oh.
That's a really, really sad answer. But I just kept looking at like the color red in my feed, and it was like making me feel hostile. Like I didn't like the color.
Well, it's so funny because you said that, and then I was like, that's a weird reason. And then you put up the screen caps of like all of your thumbnails, and I was like, oh, no, I totally get it. Like it's really in your face. What I wanted to ask you, phone related though, is obviously the 8's around the corner. Obviously, we're gonna be waiting in line. What are you hoping for out of the 8? There's so many rumors, so many different things. What's the one feature you're hoping they do when that curtain comes up?
Well, I've been using the S8, the Samsung, a lot. And what I love about it is the entire screen is just a full screen. Not necessarily, it doesn't have to be wrapped around the edges, because I also love the Pixel phone, which it just had such an incredible screen. So I'm hoping for an OLED screen, you know, full screen with the Touch ID built into
front.
In the front.
That's what we're all looking for.
It is.
That's the holy grail, isn't it, right?
It is. If they can do it, then it's going to be, you know, a huge feat, because Samsung wasn't able to do it in time. Pixel, I mean, who knows? Maybe they will do it. But, you know, definitely waterproof. Which this one also is.
Already had that, so that should be a given, right?
Facial recognition, being able to just sort of lift your phone up, because that's so awesome on the S8.
And but they got to crack it, though, because didn't somebody, I wouldn't say hack, I don't like to use the word hack, I think it gets thrown about too much these days, but somebody did use a picture of a face.
That's what I've heard. I haven't tested it, so I don't know, I can't say if it works.
Test it.
I know, I should.
You got pictures of your face in The Rock's body, you got
to
test
that's true. Oh my gosh, I'd be able to unlock it, but me as The Rock? Oh, that's good. Okay.
It becomes a feature at that point.
That's good.
At that point, it's... Oh, it's something you wanted.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's so many different things. I mean, obviously, like, I feel like a better camera, that's just one of the things that you just have to keep pushing, because a lot of people just use this as their main device to film and shoot and edit, and it's incredible.
We call it a phone. It's our phone. We have it. It is so much more than that.
It's so much more. I mean, I really could. I mean, I basically, you run your entire business off of this.
Yeah, I believe it. We're going to go to audience Q&A in a little bit. We will turn it over. But I do know that you are quite the Switch fan.
Yes. Oh.
We know you love Zelda. We know you love Mario Kart. Were you a 1-2 Switch fan? I only saw a couple of videos you playing 1-2 Switch.
I did. Yeah, I played it. It's a little hard because you actually have to move around. And then
gotta move around a little bit,
so
right?
So I'm like, well, that's too much work.
What's what would you say is your favorite of the all the different games on there? Do you have a particular favorite, or one do you think you're the best at that you think you're pretty amazing
at? I like the Quick Draw.
Are you a fan of Quick Draw?
Yes.
I'm a fan of Quick Draw too. You know, I bring it up. I only mention it because I think it would be awesome. I would be remiss if I had iJustine here on stage and we didn't engage in at least one or two rounds here of some Quick Draw.
I am excited.
What do you guys? You say you into this? You want to see a quick round of Quick Draw?
Yeah. It's right here.
All right. Here we go. Here we go. All right. We're already in the store. Let's go back. Let's go up to. All right. Oh, and wouldn't you know? What's our?
We did not plan this. This is.
All right, let's keep playing.
Oh my goodness!
Right, I'll be. Will you be red?
Yes.
All right, go ahead. You ready? If you could, I think right around here would be a good place. If you want to stand, are you a stander?
Yeah. Well, you got.
You have to, right?
Okay.
Okay. Just gotta loosen up. Gotta loosen up.
Oops! I think I shot the ground.
You jumped the gun.
I'm sorry.
That's a bad start. Quick trigger.
Okay. All right.
All right. You know how this works.
Yep.
Right here.
Your guns with the muzzle facing the ground.
You ready? Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Are you ready?
I get so nervous looking at people in the eye.
Oh, here we go. Okay. It's game time. Steady.
Oh. Fire!
Ah!
I think you got it. Here we go. Yeah.
Yes!
Round of applause. That's one.
Thank you.
Let's take a look at the stats, though. I couldn't have been that far behind, right? 4.1. Oh, wow.
Did you let me win?
No. All right. Let's go again. Rack them up. Let's go. Let's do another round. All right, bring it out. Come a little bit closer.
I'm going to back up
a little bit. No, it's fine. I'm just going to move this. All right. Here we go.
Okay.
Quick draw.
Okay.
All right.
ready for this. It's all about the eye contact.
I know, I hate it.
I know. It's the best
I'm
part.
I'm so uncomfortable
it's
right
very
now.
Very uncomfortable. But you have to so embrace that. You jump into it.
Yep.
Part of the game.
We're here.
Here we go. This is happening.
Ready.
It's a lot of tension in the room.
I'm so nervous.
It's a good vibe. I like it.
What is...
Fire!
Oh, God!
All right.
Come on. That time I had to get you.
You might have.
No!
What?
That's it. I got to hang up the gun. That's pretty. Another round of applause for our victor.
Thank you.
I tried my best. Yeah, I mean, I was closer that time. My time went down.
You probably shot me in the heart right there. So
well, I did.
I probably shot your knee.
I think so, yeah. So, knees, 100% shot me in the knees.
Depending upon damage, I think you win that one.
Well, I mean, yeah, you know what? Fair enough. I'll take it. I'll take it on a technicality.
But I still won.
Let's go ahead and take a couple of questions from our audience real quick. There should be microphones in the room. Our first one is right here to your right.
Here you go.
I'll take it back. Yeah. Perfect.
Hi.
Hello. Okay.
Did you tweet me and ask me to go to sushi?
Yeah.
I saw it.
It worked. The internet worked.
Okay, great. So, it's been mentioned a couple times, you have been on YouTube for 11 years now, and I know that a lot of your fans, including myself, have been watching you for a while.
Thank you.
Like, I've been watching you for, I think, 6 years now.
Oh, my gosh. That's so cool.
Yeah, and, like, you've inspired me a lot in so many facets, and I think one of the reasons is because I've grown up watching you almost, and I know that like throughout your videos and like while reading your book too, like I can also you can really tell a sense of like growth from you too, mm-hmm. From being online, and I want to know like what if you feel a connection between the growth of yourself and your viewers over the time you've been on YouTube.
For sure. And that's like the stories that I love hearing too. Is just I mean. You know, meeting people at events and seeing them when they were just like this tall, and then they're like, hey, I met you, and then they'll show me like, it's essentially like their baby pictures. I'm like, oh, that was us so long ago. So it has been really cool, and it has been such a growing experience too, I think, for everyone, and it's been just so fun, you know, like you and everybody that has been there since like the early times. I feel like we've all been through a lot, and I think, you know, hearing stories from other people, how I've inspired them is awesome because it's like you guys inspire me to keep going. And even when I'm having awful days and I don't talk about it, it's like I read the comments and that stuff like makes me so much happier. And just knowing and remembering why I'm doing this is to make people happy and have fun. So thank you. I won't be able to make sushi though because I have to go to another YouTube event. But next time I'm in town, maybe. But yeah, I mean, I was just sitting back there reading tweets again. So see, I read my tweets, guys. I might not always respond, but I do read them.
Pretty awesome. Another question
right
here.
Hey, Justine. So you've been in a lot of like different shows. You've been in a lot of order. I loved your little cameo in The Guild.
Thank you.
I thought that was hilarious.
Yeah.
Would you be interested in like doing more movies? Like, you know, with YouTubers, like there have been like YouTuber movies. Would you do it with like your buddies, Lily Singh and Rosanna Pansino, and or just make a movie by yourself or anything like that?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I think I've been pitching that idea too. And then it's one of those things. It's like, you have to get it right. You know, a lot of these movies, I mean, there's huge budgets involved and different partners. So it's like trying to find that right opportunity, the right script. And there's just so much that goes into it, and trying to get people's schedules on. I mean, it's insane. Like, for some of us to like do big collabs, it's like we have to schedule it out in like advance, and we've got like big X's all over the calendar. Like, listen, we're making YouTube videos with our friends this day, so nothing else can come between us. It's this day or nothing. So I think I definitely really would love to do a super fun movie, and we all have been sort of pitching some random ideas, and some ideas are out there. So hopefully, you know, in the next year or so, year or two, something super cool will finally happen.
That's one of those things that I think is inherently more difficult for creative people in your position, because all of you that I've had like the chance to talk to do so many things, and your schedule is just like cuckoo bananas all the time, always working on something. And that's got to be a really interesting change for you guys from like, well, we made these videos because we were bored and had free time and they were fun to make, to now it's like, well, this is the day that we're doing the video because it's the only day that we have.
Yeah,
it's got to be like a weird...
It is, change, but right? It's good because, you know, I making videos, I think with in the past couple of years, I started doing more videos like with my friends, and it's sort of renewed my sense of enjoyment for YouTube because, I mean, I definitely have these ups and downs where I'm like, I'm not enjoying this right now. And thankfully, my sister also makes YouTube videos, so it's great to sort of, when you're not in the mood to do it, you know, being around your friends and being around people who also love doing what you're doing too, they sort of help lift you up. And I don't know, it's just so much more fun than sitting in my room and talking to a camera, which seemingly I'm talking to no one until I post the video, and then I can have the conversation. But you know, you're not talking. So it's weird. I'm like, I can't have this conversation until after I post it.
We have time for one more, and we're going to take it, and I believe it's right in the front. But before you go, I'm going to ask one of our Twitter questions. I'm going to break the rules here.
Okay.
And go over the one question thing. So from at Sammy Schwalen, great name, what is the sweetest thing a fan has ever done for you?
Oh, my goodness. There's honestly, there's so many. I mean, from incredible letters to just awesome gifts. I know there's this one girl, this actually made me cry because, if you guys know, I love Steve Jobs, but she brought me a Lego minifigure Steve Jobs, and I about fell on the floor. I think I might have fallen on the floor, actually. And it was just, I was like, she handed it to me. I was like, is this Steve Jobs? And I just couldn't believe it. She came to one of my book events in LA, and I was just like freaking out. It was just so cool. But there's just even like letters and pictures and fan drawings, and just even like a simple tweet of, hey, I hope you're having a good day. Like anything. I mean, it's, everyone has been so sweet and so incredible. And it's those things that I remember anytime I see a hate comment. Cause I'm like, you know what? Okay, there's that one. But then there's, you know, hundreds and thousands of other people who have said so many incredibly kind things that is just so much more meaningful.
I can imagine. That's what I was thinking as like our first question was going through, and I was like, man, just like one of these has to outweigh 100 or 1 million of the bad ones.
Exactly.
Because it's so real and tangible and meaningful and awesome and like just a feel good thing.
Yeah.
So no pressure. Last question. What's up? Front row. Here we go. This is it.
Hello.
I'm Blaze. I've been watching you since when you went to the Pittsburgh game and you left little Maddie with Nate Shot at his old apartment. And I, you're the reason I got an Apple Watch and a MacBook Pro. And you actually tweeted me saying, yay. But
that's totally something you would say. That's
but my question
did
was...
Did I have one or two exclamation points? Probably
three. Four.
Okay, I was 100%. Super excited that day. Well, that's awesome.
But my question was, how do you see your channel in 10 years from now? And if you want to discuss it later at Starbucks, my guess.
I've already been to Starbucks 3 times, but I'll never say no to another trip. In 10 years, you know, I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing tomorrow. So 10 years is a super long time. But I think one of the things, you know, if I'm still doing YouTube in 10 years, that's awesome. But I think what I'm doing right now is just trying to find somebody that's able to edit half of my videos so that I can spend more time editing the other half. And it's been super helpful because I have been having some people edit some of like my cooking videos. But like for me, I want to spend more time editing my vlogs and making them better. You know, I love being able to sort of tell those fun stories of traveling and things like that, but I want to be able to be the one that's telling it. Whereas I feel like the cooking and some of the tech things, that I can let some of the creativity go because it's not that difficult. I think just trying to find an editor, because until this point I've been editing like everything, and it takes
even up to most recently.
Still now. I mean, I just edited this morning several hours for the Surface one, and then I realized halfway through that I lost the clip doing the demo.
No.
So then I exported it without the demo, and then I found the clip. So then I'm freaking out before I'm heading to a meeting. I'm like, wait, I found the clip. So then I re-edited and exported. It gets wild, and I just need incorporated.
Wow. Well, unfortunately, I have to let you go, but I can't without, after that like 10 years question, I got to know, especially within your wild tech-inclined brain, what do you think, if you could even fathom 10 years from now, what video will look like? Are people going to go VR all the way? What do you think? Like, what's a trend that we could
some
see something weird?
Sort of, I feel like, aspect of VR, or like augmented reality, I mean, we'll probably just be wearing contacts and just being like...
That's gonna happen.
Yep.
That's gonna be the thing. Just boom.
Right now, I've got Snapchat filters on you, and you don't even know what I've got.
Yeah.
Check it out on my feed.
Awesome. Well, thank you for that prediction. Thank you for indulging in playing some 1-2 Switch.
Yes.
Thank you for the questions, and thank you for generally being awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you to all
so
you guys for being a wonderful audience. Join
thanks,
me one
guys.
More time. The great iJustine.